Today, I'll tell you about some ways of food storage and preservation. You know that food gets spoiled due to microbial growth of fungus and bacteria, hence needs to be protected. Now, let's see some methods of food preservation. In many families, before starting the lunch or dinner, members pray following stanza of Sri Ramdas Swami. Vadani kavala gheta nama ghya Shri Harice Sahaja havana hote nama gheta phukace Jivana kari jivitva annahe purna brahma Udara bharana nohe janize yajna karma. Which means, food is a form of God, so should be eaten with gratitude without wasting it. Students, tell me, have you seen in your houses that usually in summer, food grains like wheat are dried in sun? Even some other delicious food items like papad, homemade chips are dried in sun. Why are these food materials dried in sunlight? What is your guess? Okay, I'll answer this. In our country, drying food items in sunlight is a traditional method. You will also see in Konkan, fishes are sun-dried. Sun-drying is a quick process to reduce moisture and does not change food taste or quality. Also, it is a very easy and cheap method. In addition to drying, refrigeration or freezing, fermentations are some of the oldest methods of food preservation. Modern food preservation methods include canning, pasteurization, irradiation, use of preservatives, etc. Now, let us know more of these methods one by one. I have earlier told you about sun-drying method. But nowadays, there are solar dryers designed for drying of food items to be stored. In solar drying, there are enclosed chambers. Food material to be dried is stored in these chambers and air in the chamber is heated using sun rays. Finally, food items get dried. Before I tell you about next method, answer my question. Why do we use refrigerators in kitchen? Here is the answer. The other method is exposing food to low temperature. During refrigeration, temperature is above the freezing point of food, that is about 0 degrees Celsius to 8 degrees Celsius. Therefore, we use refrigerators in our house to store food, fruits and vegetables, milk, etc. On the other hand, freezing means temperature is below 0 degrees Celsius or freezing point. This low temperature treatment slows down various reactions from food. Thus, taste, quality of food does not change quickly. Another method of food preservation is addition of preservatives. There are two types of preservatives as natural and artificial. Salt, sugar, oil are common natural preservatives even used in the house. Now, can you tell me names of some homemade food items in which sugar or salt or oil are added? Pickles, jams, jellies, ketchup, muramba, etc. are preserved by adding preservatives. On the other hand, sodium benzoate, sodium nitrite, sulfites, acetic acid are chemical food preservatives. All these preservatives basically prevent growth of microbes in all food items. Remember that chemical preservatives must be added in calculated amount only. Overdose of these preservatives may lead to several health problems like headache, skin rash, nausea, digestion problems, etc. Hence, regular consumption of processed food with high levels of preservatives may prove dangerous for health. Food irradiation is one of the new techniques in which food items are exposed to X-rays, gamma rays, electron beams. This treatment extends shelf life or post-harvest life of food materials. Sprouting of onions, garlic, potato, quick ripening of fruits, spoilage of vegetables can be prevented by this method. Smoking is the process in which food is preserved and also it gets cooked with a typical flavor. Very often, foods like meat, fish are smoked. In different parts of the world, a variety of materials like wood, peat, animal dung is used for smoking. Microbes from food are destroyed by smoking. Sometimes aluminium phosphate is used in smoking. But according to researchers, it is proven to be dangerous. The method of pasteurization was developed by a scientist, Louis Pasteur. This method is very effective for liquid food materials like milk. In pasteurization, food materials to be preserved is heated at high temperature, around 80 degrees Celsius, for 15 minutes. Then it is quickly chilled and stored at low temperature. This sudden rise and fall in temperature kills microbes from liquids. So students, after knowing this process, read details on milk pouches available in the market. You will find the word pasteurized milk on the pouch. This avoids spoilage of liquids. Sometimes insecticides like malathion is sprayed on the gunny bags. It kills flies, mosquitoes, mites and some other insects that may spoil food grains. But exposure to high amounts of malathions can cause health issues like headache, vomiting, difficulty in breathing, etc. Sometimes serious health problems like loss of consciousness or even death may occur. Nitrogen gas is also used in food packaging. It preserves quality of food and avoids package collapse. So far, students, you have studied various methods of food preservation. But towards the end, I am going to tell you about food adulteration. I'll give you some examples. One would find small or large stone pieces present in food grains. And then, before consuming them, those picks are necessary to separate. So, what is adulteration exactly? When food item fails to meet its standards, then it is called adulteration. To increase quantity of food, some other substance are added. Due to this, food quality lowers and may be dangerous for consumption. Now, I'll give you some common examples of food adulteration. Black pepper seeds are mixed with papaya seeds. In our country, milk is often adulterated by adding water, urea, detergent, etc. to it. Coffee powder is adulterated by adding tamarind seeds, chicory powder, etc. One may find turmeric powder adulterated with aniline dye or metanil yellow. We may find vegetable oil or animal fats in ghee, chalk powder added to sugar, brick powder or sawdust added to chili powder, and many more. There are simple tests which can be done to find out whether food is adulterated. It is very shocking to know that in our country, food adulteration has become a common practice and it is growing day by day. So here are some tips. Choose better food. Make sure that food you buy has a list of ingredients with their proportion, date of expiry, etc. Drink properly purified water. Detect food adulteration at home by simple tests. Sometimes, ingredients from food products can cause more damage to you. For example, artificial sweetness used instead of sugar cause more harm. One must not forget that even the improper way of cooking, serving, unhygienic conditions also count. Surely, by following some simple ways, we can avoid eating adulterated food. At the larger levels, more strict monitoring of all food products is necessary. Regular screening of food is must in specialized laboratories. In our country, there are laws and regulations to prevent food adulteration, like charging monetary fine, imprisonment, etc. To monitor food adulteration in our country, Food Safety and Standard Authority of India, that is FSSAI, has been established. Its head office is set in Delhi. Summary. Through this video, you have studied the concept of food preservation. Also, do not forget the fact that even if food appears colorful and may taste well, it is not always safe. Food might be adulterated in many ways. Hence, choose food properly to stay healthy.